maybe. Nobody wants to do this on a plane. Now here, here, and at the back. That's it. Okay. I also want to say, on behalf of some of the Millfield Corps and everyone that's gathered here this evening, we want to say a big thank you to the Reverend Sean Swillingbank and the church stewards for allowing us to use their church this evening. We want to say thank you to them. Just some announcements, and then we'll hand the evening over to the band. Millfield Salvation Army have meetings on a Sunday at 11 a.m. and 6 p.m. and every second Sunday in the month we have our family service, which commences at 10:30. So if you do not go anywhere else on a Sunday and you are in Sunderland, we'd be pleased to share service with you. Next weekend we have our songster weekend, and we have the visit of Edinburgh Gorgie songsters. The evening starts at 7 p.m. Tickets available this evening at £5, and the Sunday meetings are at 10:30 and 4 p.m. Also this evening are tickets available for the visit of the ISB to Millfield on September the 28th and the 29th. Again, the tickets are available at £8. And on the 5th and the 6th of October, our Harvest Weekend, led by special guests Len and Heather Ballantyne, and we have some big plans in the pipeline, ready for the Saturday and then on the Sunday. If you want to know more about Sunderland Millfield, you can check out our website on sunderlandmillfield.com. One more announcement for our friends at Concerts. Concerts have the visit of the USA Western Territories staff songsters, the newest staff songsters in the Salvation Army. And this will take place on Wednesday, the 5th of June, this year at 7 p.m. And the venue is the Concert Empire Theatre. Their tickets at the box office at £6. For further information, please contact the Concert Songster Leader. And the Songster Leader is in the audience this evening. He is, right at the back. Hi, Brian. Let's pray, and then we'll introduce the band. Heavenly Father, we come to you just now. This is your house, and we are gathered in your house to receive a great blessing. May we be inspired, may we be encouraged, may we be blessed by the ministry of the North York Temple Band and the ministry of Commissioner Bill Francis. And we just pray, Holy Father, that as they come amongst us, that they too will receive a blessing and receive the warmth of our friendship this evening. And so, Holy Father, we just hand this whole meeting over to you and ask that you will undertake, and that we will not be leaving this place disappointed, but rejoicing. In the name of Jesus, we ask all these things. Amen. It is my greatest privilege this evening to welcome. It seems a long time since some of the Millfield were asked to receive the band, and a lot of planning and a lot of prayer have gone into this evening. And here we are. And I'm sure that we're going to be richly blessed. And so I invite you to welcome a good North of England welcome to the North York Temple Band and Commissioner Francis.
Seen anything yet until you get to the North of England. and we're so, so pleased to be here in Durham, hosted by the Sunderland Millfield Pool. We've been looking forward to this for a long time now, and it is good to be here. We've been to Reading, played in front of St. Paul's Cathedral in London, went to Peterborough last night, and now we're just moving up the ladder here. And here we are in Durham. And I'm sorry we don't have time to see this beautiful part of the country. Durham University, famous around the world. As I understand it, you've got Oxford, you've got Cambridge, and then went up the ladder to Durham. And we're glad to be here. We've got our bus driver with us, by the way. Mark, you're right here in the front row. Mark's been with us all the way. He's going to leave us tonight. And we fly to Belfast tomorrow morning. But we'd like to greet you. Thank you very much, Mark, for all of you.
accessible number, He is Exalted by Edward Milkos.
Now, the lesson in all of this is listen to your chorals and your past. Thank you.
We're in for a treat now. We're going to have a euphonium cornet duet by Brendan Rollins and the Venables here, Brendan. Come over here, Brendan, because I want to interview them first. Whoa. This is a surprise for them. They did not know this, but I think it's good to, know a little bit about the members of the band, okay? So we'll start over here with Brindley. Brindley, I need to know your name. I've just given it, so. I need to know your name, and what's your position, or what do you do in life?
Well, my name is Brindley, and my boss is right over there. Bandmaster. I work for him, so that's what I do.
Is that right? What kind of a boss is he?
Oh, he's a very good boss.
Yes, and you are. You're. Are you sure you don't want to go into politics?
No.
Brindley, how long have you been with the band?
I joined in 2013. for.
You're a veteran.
Yes.
Yes. Let me go over here to Brandon. What about Brandon? What about your involvement with the bank? First of all, what do you do for a living?
Well, I'm studying to be a teacher.
What year are you in?
One and only year of teacher's college.
Right.
Who's your boss?
The wonderful tuba player in the back.
That's okay. We'll pray for you. But now, how long have you been in the band?
This is my fifth year.
Are you married?
I'm not married. No.
Any children?
Three.
Are you married to Brennan?
No.
You know, I played in bands.
We're best friends in the whole school.
Good friends, they are good friends. But you know, I played in a band for many years, and before I was married, I would just look out in the congregation, and you know, sometimes some people would catch my eye. Have you seen anyone in the congregation that you'd like to give a little gift to? We've got them right here. These are North York Temple Band water glasses. And you can buy them here for, what is it, £5. But two people are going to get them out there. So it's up to you who you want to give them to. What, you see, okay, anyone who really catches your eye, you know, either gender. But I have a feeling the way this is going. But that's okay. Yeah, you just take it to them and give it to them, okay? Right now, yeah. What do you think? You came to a concert? Of course. That's it, I'm paying. Oh, very good. Very good. Excellent. And now they're going to play for us their testimony, your testimony, my testimony, more than wonderful. Jesus, our Lord. God bless you.
Thank you.
He is wonderful. Ben's going to play now a festival number, Ballades Deus. It's written by Dean Jones. Dean Jones is in the music department at Territorial Headquarters. He has worked with the bandmaster for 18 months or so, arranging for this, so many details in a tour like this. Dean's become a good friend to the band, and he's a marvelous composer. You're going to enjoy this number, Ballades Deus, meaning the wonderful, powerful, mighty works of God. Our
Thank you.
familiar just down in New Orleans. Swinging with the Saints by Stephen Thompson. Before we start the second half, I want to introduce a former Salvation Army bandsman, professional trumpet player, well known throughout the area, and that's Clarence Adu. Right over here, Clarence.
Thank you.
I mean, that was good singing. Now, you're going to hear what I promised you would hear at the beginning. Rather than Fantasia for cornet, you're going to hear Fantasy for trombone by Barrington Fenelon. Barrington, come on up here. Now, I hope you didn't think you were going to get away with out of an interview.
Let's just change channels here.
I'll just turn this on.
Give us your name and what you're doing for a living. Let's start with that.
All right. My name is Barrington Keith Venables. It's my full name. I work for Glenn as well.
You work for Glenn too. What do you think about him as a boss? I mean, you can be honest, we're among friends here.
He's pretty good. He's learning. And,
trying to train him.
Yeah.
Well, that's all in the past. Yeah. How long have you been with the band?
Oh gosh, since 2000, I guess. Yeah.
So are you in university now?
I graduated last year.
Where from and with what degree?
University of Toronto with a Bachelor of Music and Performance.
Excellent. You know, in fact, I saw you. I'm sitting right here seeing the trombones right over here. I can straight shot there. I saw you looking out at the congregation. Are you married?
No, actually.
No. Would you like to be married someday?
You know, that's...
Okay, that's enough. We don't want the long, hard, sad story, you know? But I wonder if there's anyone out there that's caught your eye. You know? Because this happens, you know. I met my wife in a party at the University of Florida. I just saw her. Well, anyway, I won't tell you the whole story. But what about you? Do you see anybody? Just take your time. We've got all night. Okay, got somebody? Here we go. Who will it be? One of you have this lucky. One of you are the lucky winners. Take your time.
Oh.
Little drum roll. Little drum roll here. Hey! Excellent. Who got it? Stand up. What's your name? What? Caitlin. Okay, Caitlin. You know, that means that you got to come up and talk to a parent. You know, tell them where you're going to school, all of that. Okay? Good, Caitlin. Well, Barrington is a wonderful trombonist, a man of God, loves the Lord, faithful, and he's going to play Fantasy for Trombone. Let's give him a hand. By the way, it's by R.S.A. Who's that? I don't know anybody else in the world that goes by their initials, but this great composer, this dean of composers for this generation, who's now in his 90th year, still going strong, has written this great piece, Fantasy for Trombone. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to turn our thoughts to a quieter time now. The band's going to play a hymn tune arrangement of Now I Belong to Jesus by Stephen Ponsford. You know, when we're young, going to church, going to the core, we don't remember a lot of things. I don't think we remember too many sermons, unfortunately, that the core officers gave to us as young people. We don't remember that. We remember they were good, but we can't remember it. But one thing we remember is consistency. The core I grew up in Troy, New York, every Sunday night, we ended the service singing Now I Belong to Jesus. After the Sunday meeting was all over, it boiled down to that fact. Now I belong to Jesus. I remember that. And I remember the love and support of all those in the core. And every Sunday night, before school the next week, I was reminded I belong to Jesus. Let's be reminded of that today as we listen to the band and then we look to the scripture for a few moments following the playing of Now I Belong to Jesus.
Thank you. chapters F, Psalm 118, is at the heart of Scripture. And you know, I believe that nothing, no detail escapes God's eyes. This is at the heart of Scripture. The Psalm before it is the shortest chapter in the Bible. Psalm 117, 2 verses. And of course, as you know, the Psalm after it, Psalm 119, is the longest Psalm. And then we find Psalm 118. It's a Psalm that Jesus and his disciples last read together. Because you see, Psalm 118 is the end of what the Jewish people call the Hallel. The Hallel is Psalm 113 to 118. And during Passover, every year, in every Jewish home around the world, they read the Hallel. First half of it is read before the supper. And then after supper, as they take the last cup of wine, grape juice, the cup of praise, they say the last chapter together of the Hallel. Hallel means praise. So there's no question that the last chapter, the last scripture that Jesus read with his disciples was Psalm 118. The New Testament describes it as a hymn. They probably chanted it more than said it as we read it. And you'll remember that in the accounts of the New Testament, it says, after they had sung it, they went to the Garden of Gethsemane. So Jesus read this with his family as a 6-year-old, as a 7-year-old in Nazareth. Jesus read it with his family all the way up while he was growing up. Every year of his life, he read this on Passover. Martin Luther said that it was his favorite psalm. General John Larson said that his favorite verse is Psalm 118:24. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. There are wonderful promises in this psalm. I wonder if Jesus knew as a young lad, sitting around the table with Mary and Joseph, his brothers and sisters as he grew up. And he came to verse 23, and it says, the stone the builders rejected has become the capstone. Did he know that that was him? Well, at some point, yes, he did. I wonder when that came to him. Was it when he was talking to the scribes in the temple? When he was 12 years old, the bar mitzvah boy, going to Jerusalem with his father and mother, and they couldn't find him, and where was he? He was talking to the scribes. He was talking to the leaders of the Jewish nation. Did he know it was him? I think so. The stone the builders rejected has become the capstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Another part of the scripture for us tonight says, the Lord's right hand has done mighty things. The Lord's right hand is lifted high. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. As I was reading this, I was hearing my wife's voice as part of her testimony. She often raises her hand. And if you want a good hallelujah in the meeting, ask my wife to be there.
She praises the Lord from the depths of her heart. But she often says in her testimony and refers to this verse because God
Almighty, the Lord's right hand is lifted high. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. And the final verse, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. What a great promise that is. His love endures forever. The band's going to play a piece entitled Everywhere. And it's about God's love enduring forever. You know, it doesn't mean just that God's love in a general sense endures, that he's always loved. God's love endures in your life forever. God's love endures forever, through the good times, through the bad times. And when we're on top of a mountain, it feels very good. But when we go through the valley, as the psalmist said, yea, though I walk through the valley, I'd love to walk around some of these valleys. But we have to walk through the valley. God's right hand is there. His love endures forever. John Gowans wrote the words that you will hear in this piece. We have here today the writer of the tune, Andrew Maycock. Where are you, Andrew? Raise your hand. Just stand up. I just want to recognize you because it's a team effort. God bless you. Thank you. And then the composer of this marvelous piece is right over here, Marcus Fenelis. Marcus, by the way, was the composer of the first piece they played, the band played at the beginning of Abundance. And he put his talents together to pull together John Brown's words, Andrew Maycock's beautiful tune. And now the band is going to play, and we're going to listen to the words. Here's the first verse of John's words. Looking over the bastions of heaven today, God bless you, John. We miss you. Have you ever stopped to think how God loves you? It sounds quite incredible, and yet it's true. Nothing on this earth or in the heavens above is as sure and certain as God's love. The chorus goes on to say, oh, it's as high as the sky, and it's as deep as the sea, and it's as wide as the world, God's love for you and me. We can't escape his love or take ourselves out of his care. So where could we hide from his love? His love. Now, this is programmed music at its best. It gives a picture. And it's not a picture that you put on the screen. It's an individual picture that you have to put in your mind, and I have to put in my mind. Listen to the music. The picture is of an individual, perhaps yourself, who finds God's love, who finds Jesus Christ in his life, and God fills him with his. And then more come as he witnesses. More men and women, friends come. And then comes the trial of life. You have trials in your life? We all do. And some of them begin to doubt, and you'll hear the band, the doubt coming from the lower end of the band, the struggle. In the middle of the piece, you'll hear the chorus. Keep reminding everybody, God's love is everywhere. So tonight, brothers and sisters, whether you're on the mountain and you hear the cornet very clearly, or you're in the valley and you understand the turmoil that we're going through, God's love never fails. He'll never fail. His promises are sure. So wherever you are on the journey, picture the journey. Keep looking toward God, and may his love fill your life tonight as the band plays.
I'm lost for words, and I just want to say tonight's been awesome, amazing, and God-inspired. And I want to say thank you to the North York Temple Band under the leadership of Bandmaster Glenn, and also the Commissioner's words of wisdom this evening. Let's say thank you to them.
And that's exciting for we who are not as young.
I still picture myself with dark hair, but every morning I'm reminded that time's going by. But this band, the youngest member is 16. The oldest member is a little older, 69. The average age of the band is 29. However, the cornet section here, look at this cornet section. Look how young they look. From there on, look at the cornet section just like this, see? Okay. The average age of the cornet section is 24. But if you just take one member off, the age is 21. So we're in good hands for the future, and we praise the Lord for that. We're going to be praying for you, and I know you represent many core churches here, this beautiful church. Anybody here from the church, from the Methodist Church? Anybody at all? Thank you, brother, for coming. Anybody else? Anybody glad to be a Methodist? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! You know, we're grandchildren of the Methodists. William Booth was a Methodist preacher in the Methodist New Connection. So, we're just home. Thank you for welcoming us home. You want to hear the band one more number? Encore for the North York Temple Band. Please join me in prayer. Father, this has been a wonderful night, and we praise your name for it. You lifted us above a concert. You lifted us beyond display of talent. And this, we pray, will continue to be a musical offering to you. All of us here today are in divine presence, and we thank you for your blessing, for your Holy Spirit has spoken into us. And now we receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you